Jim.
Good, how are you?
Very good.
Awesome. Thank you.
Hey brother,
I got you.
Good job, bro.
Sorry about that.
What's that?
I'm not sure.
You look good in that hat.
Yes, sir.
I'll see you out there.
All right.
First of all, congratulations. How's it feel to be around?
What a shout.
There was some talk you might have been in New York, but I guess at the end, Al Davis thought you were too good to pass up, huh?
No. I heard a lot of talk about between New York and Oakland, so I was happy with wherever I go. I was ready to get the process over. It's been a long, grueling process. It's something you're ready to get it over with and get somewhere and play ball.
Is a dream come true for you and a chance now to show everybody, you know, how good Dan McFadden is, right?
It's a dream come true. It's something you've been living your life for, to play football since day one. I've been playing since I was 6 years old, and it's always been a dream of mine to be able to play in the NFL and hear my name called. It was a big relief.
How did it make you feel when, you know, Jet fans wanted you to be a part of their team, and you know they got disappointed today?
I'm sorry they got disappointed, but Oakland decided to go ahead and grab me, and I'm glad to be there now.
Hey, which Raider are you looking forward to meeting the most?
I just want to get out there and meet the guys like Jamarcus Russell, Justin Fardy, and just get to meet those guys and be around them and learn the offense from them.
Have you seen the playbook at all before? Have you had a chance to go with Coach Kiffin at all? Playbook?
Yes, sir. I haven't got a chance to go through it or anything.
Darren, what do you want to say to the Jet fans here in New York?
Sorry, Jet fans. I didn't get a chance to come here.
Was there a time you thought you would be a Jet?
Through the process, there was something I was thinking about. The Jets were the team that showed the most interest in me. So I was thinking that I would be a Jet.
Hey, are you all used to all these mics around you now?
Yeah, it's something. When I went through the Heisman campaign, I did have to do a lot of interviews and things, so it's something I got pretty used to real quick.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Darren, you're a new Raider. What do you do?
I'm glad to be here. I know the Raiders have a lot of good history. I know the past few years hasn't been as good for them as it has been. Something I feel like I can go out there and help them out.
Have they ever talked to you about the Raider philosophy, the Raider way? Did Mr. Davis talk to you about that?
No, sir. I haven't got a chance to talk with him about that.
Like, we don't lose to the Chiefs. We don't lose to the Broncos.
No, sir.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay.
In Mexico, I have a million of Raiders fans. Do you want to say something else?
Hey, y'all getting a great player. You know, the guy that won't let you down in his offense.
Thank you very much.
Just we get you pairs, man. What do you feel like doing right now if you didn't have a plane to catch?
I just want to relax right now. I had so much going on this week. I'd love to just get a chance to relax for a second.
Was it fun?
But it was a great week, but I enjoyed the whole thing. It was a long process, but I enjoyed the whole week.
You can get a chance to go back to Little Rock before you go out to Oakland for good?
Right now I don't know what my plans are. I don't know if I'm going to be leaving here, going to Oakland, or leaving here and going back to Arkansas.
Darren, have you thought about being that far away from Arkansas out there in California?
It's going to be a long way from home, but my sister's going to keep me company out there. It won't be too bad. I'm sure my family they come out and visit anytime they want. I'm a big boy now. I got to move on.
When you think about the Raiders, what do you remember? What are your thoughts?
You always remember the silver and black, and then the fans. They're like SEC fans. They're always there.
Remember Bo Jackson? Did you watch him as a kid or anything?
I think I might have been a little young to watch Bo run.
Have you seen him on tape or any of that?
I've seen tape of him. He's a great running back. He's a guy that you want to accomplish things like he did.
Has Coach Willie Brown assured you with any of his wisdom with you as a Raider legend?
No, I haven't got a chance to talk to anyone and share any wisdom about the Raider Nation or the legends that they have out there. Mm-hmm. But, I know a guy like Marcus Allen is a legend for the Raiders. I've met him a couple times, and he's a great guy.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Darren, I think you tie for the highest Razorback ever drafted in the NFL, especially since it's been this many teams. What does that mean to you?
It's a great honor, because I guess people, when you think of Arkansas football, people don't feel like a lot of great players come out of there, but, you know, it's just something that goes to show, you know, Arkansas do produce great football players.
You said it hadn't really sunk in yet the other day. Has it sunk in now?
I don't think it's still sunk in. You know, it probably won't sink in until I'm out there and playing ball and out there with all the other veterans.
It's all sort of a blur, huh, still?
it's like a blur to me, you know. When I get there and get in training camp, everything's going to hit on me then.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, Darren, you think playing at Arkansas and the two Heisman runners-up and just that experience has helped you go through the draft and helped you go through all of this?
It's helped me out a whole lot, you know, just being able to deal with the media. You know, you have to always have a positive outlook. You can't go in with a negative attitude towards it. So it's something that helped me out a whole lot.
Darren, from Japanese to Tokyo, what do you think about this high volume of media attention globally?
I guess being one of the top rated players in the draft is something that you're going to get a lot of attention, get a lot of scrutiny. It's something that I've been dealing with it pretty well, and I've been enjoying the whole process.
Darren, you think you'll run any of the wildcat or wild hog in the NFL?
Hey, you never know. You know, they might decide to throw a player two in, put him back there quarterback, but I don't know as of right now.
Would you like that?
You know, I love it. I always love going back there being able to run the offense.
Hey, Darren, could you look here and say hi to the Bay Area people in Oakland?
Yeah, I'm doing it in the Bay Area.
There's a certain mystique that seems to be around the Raiders. Is that something that you're excited about, know anything about? Have you been told about that?
Right now, I don't know. I really don't know much about it at all.
Yeah.
It's about toughness under pressure.
I feel like I'm a guy that performs very well under pressure. Toughness is there. You know, I've been in the SEC, playing. It's a tough league to play in, so it's something that won't be a problem for me at all.
And it's about being smooth, which you seem to know about, so there you go.
I feel like I know a whole lot about it. You know, I feel like the SEC ball has prepared me very well for the NFL and being ready to be a Raider.
It's also about knowing where to get good food, so go to Cafe Verbena when you're at Oakland. It's a great place.
I'm going to have to try that out.
you think you'll look faster in gold and black?
Probably
Steelers,
look, it might look like a Blair now, you know. Yeah. See the silver hanging off the jersey while you're running.
Well, it's pretty sleek. I mean, is it? You like those colors?
Yeah, it's a sweet color play. I feel like I'm going to be very
good. People want to know who you're backing for president. You got a first choice?
Right now, I haven't did my research out of the way, so I don't have a choice.
I bet you hadn't been asked that before.
First time.
Thanks, man. Congrats. All right,
yeah. Thank you.